Hey, duh. If you do anything wrong in your life, duh, and I find out about it, I'm going to try to take everything away from you. And I don't care what I find out. It could be today, tomorrow, 15, 20 years from now. If I find out, you're fucking duh finished. Who's that? That's you. That's what the audience sounds like to me. That's why I don't be coming out doing comedy all the time, because y'all niggas is the worst motherfuckers I've ever tried to entertain in my fucking life.
Are you surprised, though, by the criticism that's come your way?
No. And I don't mind that people get upset. Some of this criticism, like, is helpful. Like, I get educated by it. I don't necessarily agree with all of it. Mm-hmm. But I learn about a lot of things, you know, just from my critics.
I am not saying that to say that trans women aren't women. I am just saying that those pussies that they got, you know what I mean? I'm not saying it's not pussy, but that's like beyond pussy or impossible pussy. You know what I mean? It tastes like pussy, but that's not quite what it is, is it? It's not blood, that's beet juice. But you guys gotta remember, I'm not saying it to be mean. I'm saying it because it's funny. And everything's funny till it happens to you.
If bad things happen to someone else, that's not necessarily funny.
Look at it this way. I grew up in the crack epidemic. I tell jokes about it. I grew up in the crack epidemic, and now there's an opioid epidemic. Mm-hmm. Are they treating the opioid epidemic the way that they treated the crack epidemic? Yeah. No, this is a national health emergency. When we were coming up, we were policed by the National Guard. Addicts were criminals. Now they understand addicts are sick people. And maybe it's because of the demographic of the opioid epidemic is not the same demographic of the crack epidemic.
Racially. I mean, right. You're talking about race.
Right. So now that your community is getting destroyed, it's a whole nother ball game. And then it's a huge window of empathy. Oh my God, we can see each other. We both went through similar pain. But I'm just saying, everything's funny till it happens to you is more about empathy. That you there but for the grace of God.
I don't wanna call you back if you don't feel my love. I don't wanna sit with your heart. Nah, nah. And even though you're the one, I'ma let go for now. I'ma let go.
But there's a more important reason that I would stop doing comedy right now. And this reason is the real reason that's been percolating, and it really is the crowd, not you. I'm talking about the crowd on the big stage.
It's too hard to entertain a country whose ears are so brittle. Motherfuckers are so sensitive, the whole country is turned into bitch-ass niggas. Everything you say upsets somebody. You know, I can remember when it all started. It was when I was doing Chappelle's Show. When I was doing Chappelle's Show, I used to do the show, and then on the weekends I do like concerts and shit like that. So I'm doing a concert, and there was a couple in the front row, beautiful couple. The wife was obviously Asian. You could see it in her face. The husband. This motherfucker was mysterious, to say the least. Couldn't quite pinpoint where he was from. Caramel-colored fella, very nice hair, but he could have been from anywhere. Bangladesh, Mexico. I can't guess with a nigga like this. All I knew for sure about this guy is that his wife was a bitch. I could see that in her face, too. No, he was laughing and having a good time, and she was scowling at me at a goddamn comedy show. I couldn't figure it out. And then I realized at some point that she was pregnant And I was smoking on stage. I said, oh my God, that's probably why she's mad. So I started to put my cigarette out, but then she hit me with one of them fake non-smoker calls. So I just kept smoking. I thought to myself, bitch, that babe will be fine, relax.
And I tried to break the tension. I just asked her, that's all I said. I go, hey, where are you guys from anyway? And I could tell that she was on to me. She goes, very condescendingly, she says, I'm from California. If you're asking my ethnicity, I am Chinese. And her husband was just cool about the shit. He was like, I'm Mexican, bro. I said, well, I'm sorry if I offended you by asking.
But you're a very beautiful couple. And miss, there's no question that you're gonna give birth to the hardest working baby this world has ever seen. That's not a bad joke. She got very upset. She got up to leave immediately, but she didn't just leave. She had to take one last dig at me on the way out. I will never buy one of your fucking DVDs again, Dave Chappelle.
I said, ma'am, with all due respect, Chinese people don't buy DVDs. And the crowd went crazy. We were all laughing, having a good time. I didn't even think anything of it. And then just 3 days later, this lady sends a fucking letter to my promoter telling him not to book me for shows anymore.
Because I was, quote, racist, huh? And I'm quoting her, insensitive to the nature of my interracial marriage. I was like, oh, word, bitch, I was. If she had just done a little bit of research, she would know that I myself am in an interracial marriage. That's right. In fact, my wife is Asian too. Surprise, bitch, I'll see you on Thanksgiving. But my wife's not Chinese. She's Filipino. That's right, that's right. And our kids are Puerto Rican somehow, so there you go. I don't give a fuck about interracial marriage. In fact, you know what? My mother is half white.
A lot of people don't know that. Well, all right, you were a little too excited, but okay. A lot of people don't believe me when I say that, but it's true. You can't tell looking at me, but if I grew my hair out, you would think you was at a fucking Cat Williams concert. My shit is beautiful. But motherfuckers are just taking it too far. I don't know why or how everybody got this goddamn sensitive. You know who hates me the most? The transgender community.